We recently attended a barbecue for Memorial Day and someone brought curry chicken as a side dish. They said that they picked it up from Whole Foods, but it was so delicious that I decided that I'm going to try to replicate it. Welcome to the Bear Pantry Show. If you're looking for authentic Belizean recipes, then you're in the right place. My name is Barbara, and this is Cooking Made Simple.
Mom, you know what you're doing?
Not really, but we're going to figure it out. This is going to be one of these tests on camera recipes because I want to replicate this curry chicken that we had at that backyard barbecue on Memorial Day. So I feel like they put coconut milk in it because it felt, well, it tasted creamy. And of course they have curry. And I'm going to put onion. We're going to wash the chicken with the vinegar because that's what we Belizeans do. And we're just going to fly by the seat of our pants. So let's go over to the sink and wash the chicken.
These are the ingredients that I decided to use for the dish. Go ahead and screenshot this. Now let's get back to the washing of the chicken. So I'm just going to pour some distilled white vinegar on this. Rinse it off with some water. I just recently saw a whole debate on YouTube about people washing the meats and not washing the meats. I found it very interesting because you guys know that I'm Belizean. So that's why we were taught to do this. So let's see what I'm going to use. Salt. Pepper, black pepper, and let me get a little bit. I'm not gonna put a whole lot because we can taste later.
All right, guys, I'm just gonna start with a little because we're gonna taste it while it's cooking. I'm not gonna put any paprika or Belizean ricotta because the chicken did not look really brown when they brought it. It was mostly colored by the curry. So let me get some extra virgin olive oil. We're gonna go over to the stove and get it in our pan.
Now, if you don't have olive oil, you can use any type of oil that you cook with, all right? It could be vegetable oil, canola oil, you know, anything that you use to just brown the meat with, I think you'll be good. So let me go ahead and put the pieces in. And this seasoned water that's left behind is not blood. Like people like to tell me, oh, it's the blood. No, it's just the water that's left from seasoning the meat. It's not red, of course, because I didn't put any of the Belizean ricotta. By the way, I saw on TV that the month of June is Caribbean Appreciation or Caribbean People Appreciation Month, something like that. So I guess this is a good dish to put out for today, right? So I'm just moving the pieces around to allow it to brown without burning. I'm using my new pan that I got from Costco a few weeks ago. Now this is some diced up onions and you can use a small onion or half of a medium onion. Just toss it in here because I did taste some onion in the dish. Now see the water has reduced. So now let me go ahead and put the leftover seasoned water and then some of the coconut milk. So I've just pierced two holes in the top of the tin and I'm just gonna pour what I think is half. And then 1 tablespoon of the curry powder because this can be spicy, so we don't want it to overwhelm certain people's palates. Just give this a stir. And allow this to cook until it reduces. See? Took about, I'd say 25 minutes. It's reduced somewhat. And I'm going to put a little bit more water in it. Just to allow it to steam a little bit longer. Then I'm going to taste. And adjust for salt and pepper if it's needed. But it's not needed. And once it's reduced again, it's done. So I'm going to serve it with white rice. And let me get some. And you can always reduce it some more if you don't want too much of the gravy, all right? Especially if you're taking it to a barbecue and you're using it as a side dish along with other barbecue type things, you can reduce some more of the gravy. Now you guys are outside with me as I fight for a little bit of sun. It's been overcast. See, it's too much sun on this table. It's going to have too much shadow, so I have to use this table. Take my little shot.
Guys, this curry messes up everything, so watch your counter, all right? So, Joshua just tasted it off camera and said, I think you got it, Mom. Mm-hmm. Yes. You know, I don't take Belizean food to barbecues. And it's because stewed chicken doesn't go with barbecue. Rice and beans doesn't go with barbecue. So all I can take is like potato salad and maybe some milk cake or some other type of dessert, right? So I normally just take, you know, some kind of macaroni salad and some chocolate cake. But next time, I'm taking this because everybody was raving about that curry chicken. I should have cut the pieces a little bit smaller. It's okay, though. With some white rice. Mm-hmm. The curry is not too hot. And so I'm gonna like tone down the black pepper a little bit. So this would go for all palates. Put a little bit more curry, maybe some more black pepper, and then it'll be just a little bit spicy that the kids could handle. You guys notice nowadays, kids could handle heat more than adults. It's because of those hot Cheetos and Takis and stuff like that. Anyways, this is good. I'm glad I decided to replicate it. I'm still chewing the meat. Try it, guys. Very simple, all right? I'll put the recipe, the ingredients in earlier in the video so you guys can grab it. And this is one of these tests on cameras that actually came out. I'll see you guys soon. Bye-bye.
Thanks for watching. Don't forget to subscribe and hit that notification bell so you can know when I upload another video. Also, check out my Belizean cookbook at barepantryshow.com. Bye now.